everyone need for peace, everyone need for good life. We also need for studying, for learning. We are not alive in this country for to kill by bad people. We eat same, we are look same, we walking same, we talking same. No different between the humans. We need for help. My name is Nur Ahmad Sherzad. I'm from Afghanistan.
My name is Abdul Sabur. I'm from Afghanistan, 26 year old, and I leave Afghanistan 19 months ago. And I came to Pakistan and Iran, and from I was in Iran in prison, and I deport back from Iran to Afghanistan, and I try again and again. I came to Pakistan, and from Pakistan to Iran, from Iran to Turkey, and from Turkey to Bulgaria, and I came here to Serbia.
Como tantos cubanos, salimos de Cuba huyendo a las represalias del gobierno por problemas políticos, problemas económicos, ambos ligados. Y una de las rutas que nos quedaba en el momento de salir era Europa. Y en Europa solo hay cuatro países que no le piden visa a los cubanos. Rusia, Bielorrusia, Montenegro y Serbia.
My name is Rahila Sherzai. Your name? She's name? Ruhina. I'm going to game.
Crius tenen bon cor, d'entrada. Quan els veus així en massa, que veus allò 500 alumnes en un institut, tens ganes de sortir corrents, no?, i de desaparèixer. Però després, quan parles amb ells, tots tenen ganes d'ajudar. Són bones persones. El que passa és que els hi falta una formació per poder ajudar els altres. Llavors aquí és on el paper del profe pot ajudar a orientar-los de cara a veure quins potencials tenen i on poden ser més útils en aquesta societat.
Penso que l'ajuda concreta amb una persona sempre és important. Probablement els voluntaris no poden canviar el món, no poden canviar les grans estructures, els grans problemes geopolítics, però penso que ajudar a una persona concreta en un moment determinat, donar un cop de mà, donar un cop d'aigua, donar unes sabates, penso que això és molt important per aquella persona i per tant penso que és absolutament vàlid. I a més penso que això construeix la maduresa també del voluntari, no? Que l'ajuda a formar-se com a persona. Penso que el voluntariat d'alguna forma complementa les persones. La voluntat aquesta de servei d'alguna forma et reconcilia amb la humanitat i també et reconcilia amb tu mateix. Nosaltres, que som persones doncs, que ho tenim pràcticament tot resolt, doncs amb moltes coses resoltes, en el moment en què podem donar un cop de mà, jo penso que això com a persona se'ns complementa. I penso que aquest és un dels estímuls fonamentals. Aquestes persones se senten més ben belles mateixes després de fer això que no pas siguin els purs espectadors.
Jo penso que ajudar als altres fa a tothom més feliç. I a la gent de l'edat dels instituts, moltíssim. Fins que no ho fan, no veuen la felicitat que els comporta ajudar als altres.
Humanity Wings, el que ara és una associació benèfica, neix com un treball de recerca, com un projecte de final de curs de dos estudiants de primer de batxillerat en aquell moment que volen fer alguna cosa per ajudar els refugiats sirians. No és el mateix veure una cosa a través de la televisió que veure-la davant teu. Quan saps que hi ha gent que està passant gana, hi ha gent que està fugir, obligada a fugir del seu país, hi ha gent que està demanant ajuda a Europa i Europa els està tancant les portes, te n'adones que no et pots limitar només a enviar-los i menjar i roba i diners i quedar-te a caseta tranquil·lament. Que has de fer alguna cosa, que has d'anar allí. I així sorgeix una mica l'associació. El que en principi som tres persones que viatgem en el primer viatge acaba sent un grup nombrós de gent que s'inclou dins de l'organització Humanity Wings i que hem estat treballant primer a Grècia i després a Sèrbia, tant a Belgrat com a la frontera.
One day I got sick of my job and felt like I wasn't really doing enough to help the world, so I quit my job, bought a van and drove to Greece. Stayed in Greece for around a month, and then just as I was about to leave actually and was, I'd booked my ferry ticket to go home, I found out about the barracks in Belgrade and saw the whole situation there. That would have been in mid-January when it was really, really cold. And myself and a friend who was also there with the van just kind of said to each other, you know, we've got to do something about this. We've been working in heaven in northern Greece, you know, and like 7 hours drive away, there's people who are freezing. So we just went to a couple of warehouses and said to them, look, we're driving to Serbia, we need to help. What can you give us? You know, we need blankets, we need coats, we need things to make people warm. I had some money left in my crowdfunder that I did before I set off, and I bought a load of kitchen equipment. And yeah, we hit the roads. We have such a diverse group of people that come and work with us. You know, it's very difficult to kind of set a pigeonhole on the type of people who come. This organization is probably the youngest in sort of terms of demographics that I've worked with. I would say quite often the average age of volunteers here is 23. You know, we've had people from all over the world, from Japan to Peru, Spain, you know, America, pretty much everywhere, you know. The plan was only to stay in Serbia for 2 days, meet with some people and drop the stuff off and go. And 7 months later, I'm still here.
La organización de este festival surge un poco a raíz de otro festival similar que organizamos el año pasado, aquí también en Belgrado, bueno, como una iniciativa un poco proporcionarles a los migrantes un día pues, de diversión, en el que simplemente pueden pasárselo bien y compartir su comida y sus bailes y donde podamos aprender de ellos y de su cultura y sus costumbres. Y fue bastante bien, la idea era un poco pues, también de atraer a la población local. De la opinión pública en Serbia es un poco particular en comparación a otros países europeos, porque bueno, Serbia es un país, no sé si llamarlo pobre, pero que ha sufrido una crisis económica y política muy importante durante los últimos años y en el que hay una tasa de desempleo enorme y en el que el salario mínimo son 300 euros. Entonces la gente digamos que tiene un poco esa conciencia de tenemos suficiente con lo nuestro. De hecho, hay ONGs que se encargan de llevar la comida todos los días a los campos porque el gobierno es incapaz de proporcionarles una dieta en condiciones, lo cual es alarmante.
First 5 days, I was decided to apply here for asylum. Here some organization, they work for refugee. And one day I was wake up from sleep. I was been that time in barracks, here old barracks behind the train. And now the refugee moved by government from that barracks to camps, all in the center. And I was asked from one organization, I wanna apply here for asylum. I was been there for 2 months. And I was helped there for some organization about language, Pashto, Farsi, a little bit Urdu, English. And I was happy there with that organization, with my friends, refugee, everyone. And I spent a lot of nice time there.
This place was founded in 2015 during the biggest influx of refugees to Europe, like this, when this big Europe refugee crisis started. And like a lot of refugees and migrants were passing through this part of Belgrade because the train station is here and the bus station is here. So their journey had to be like, they had to go through this part of town. And at one point, a lot of people started to gather in park, you know, and they slept in parks while they wait for the next transportation. And then citizens of Belgrade, they started to gather here spontaneously and brought all this humanitarian aid. But it's different now because these people are here and we are seeing them every day and we have to build a relationship with them without some negative effects, you know.
Cricket is an important part of life for the people from the Indian subcontinent, including Afghanistan. So cricket is by far the most popular sport. Commissariat and the other NGOs, they tried to involve them in some other activities, like organizing football, volleyball, basketball, or whatnot for them. For those people who are stuck in Serbia, for more than 6 months, some of them have been stuck in the camps for over a year, who are getting a bit downhearted, apathetic, depressed, without any tangible goal. At least like twice a week, they can think of themselves as a good sportsman, not as some refugee who is stuck in a camp and doesn't know where to go.
I think it would be great if some of them would like to stay. I mean, it's always, you have to integrate those people. That's absolutely a must, because they should feel also accustomed to the local culture and the local customs. And they're really very smart. And I think for them, it wouldn't take them long. So I will be very, very happy if some of them want to stay.
Volunteering is not still very popular in Serbia. I think you can see among younger generations that definitely they're getting more and more involved. But volunteering in general still has a long way to go here in the country. And I think the main reason is not that people are not interested or aware of the needs for volunteers in different fields, but simply have a lot of their own issues to focus on, and it is not easy for them to find the time to do it. But yeah, it is picking up among young people, and that's really good.
I was in prison for 2 days, and they said leave Serbia in 5 days. If I not leave Serbia in 5 days, I'm going to prison for 6 months or maybe 1 year. I meet a lot of people, and I meet people all around the world here in Belgrade, because especially volunteering, they are coming from different places, from different area, and I used to work with them together on the barracks. When the barracks it was exist, and I was work with them together on the barracks to cook and chop all the woods and thing, yeah.
Creo que el trabajo que estamos haciendo es muy útil. Es muy útil, es necesario. Muchos refugiados están en campos todo el día sin ningún tipo de actividad, sin ningún tipo de distracción, todo el día pensando cómo voy a salir de aquí, de la desesperanza que tienen, la frustración constante, bueno, todo lo que ya sabemos, ¿no? Y el generar una actividad que los saque un poco de la rutina y también el decirles, estamos aquí y os apoyamos y os queremos y... Bueno, es una parte que aunque no es supervivencia, también es importante, ¿no? Porque ayudas en el estado psicológico a lo mejor de una persona, que es fundamental. En cuanto puntualmente a las distribuciones de agua y de comida, es bastante evidente, ¿no? Porque es comer y es algo que hay que suplir sea como sea.
Ahora mismo estamos... O sea, yo y otro grupo más de diferentes países, cerca de la frontera, muy cerca de la frontera con Hungría, intentando cruzar, pero con la doble valla, con todo el control fronterizo se hace un poco difícil. Entonces no tenemos acceso al abastecimiento. Y gracias a las ONG, como Humanity Wings, que nos brindan alimento, agua potable, ropas, calzado, mantas para el frío. Gracias a Médicos Sin Fronteras, que vienen frecuentemente y nos atienden a ver si estamos enfermos, si tenemos alguna dolencia. Yo estuve en un campo, antes de estar aquí, estuve en un campo aquí en Serbia. Y no hay muchas ayudas en ese campo como tal. Estando aquí, aquí en este pedazo de selva, he recibido más ayuda en menos tiempo que todo el tiempo que estuve en el campo. Y prefiero estar aquí antes que en un campo, por salir de Cuba buscando libertad. Y en un campo no tengo libertad. Aquí tengo mucha más libertad. Me siento más libre. Y tengo más esperanzas de llegar a mi destino que estando en un campo en Serbia.
No sé si creo que sea correcto que estén fuera de los campos, pero están obligados a estar fuera de los campos cuando no tienen unas condiciones en los campos que les permitan tener un mínimo de calidad de vida, un mínimo de vivir. Es decir, si yo estoy en un campo y me quiero ir a la ciudad a tomarme un café con alguien, darme cuenta que no puedo ir. Lo que es nuestro trabajo, ahora en este momento en SYBS, pues tenemos, digamos, lo que puede ser abarcar un desayuno comida, que es, lo damos a las 11 de la mañana, donde siempre damos un huevo cocido, siempre les damos té, luego la fruta que viene fresca todos los días, y luego damos una cena a las 7 de la tarde. En esos momentos pues ya nos rejuntamos, son los momentos donde estamos con los refugiados, tanto los voluntarios, y hay voluntarios que son una maravilla con la percusión y se montan sus talleres de música, desde los talleres de distintas clases, tenemos unos diccionarios hechos que salieron en las barracas en Pashto, en Dari, en Urdu, ahora en árabe.
I'm going to try to go soon, but when I'm going to shit, I went there yesterday and I was start cooking with them also. There are people cooking, like volunteering. If I'm going to shit and I try to cross the border, and also when I came back, I know people from Noonam kitchen, they are there, and I'm cooking with them. And try from there and come back, when I'm come back, and then I'm cooking.
Distributions try to focus on mutual respect and dignified ways of giving aid, which is often not done. Often people bring stuff to camps without an idea of how many people there are, if they have enough of the right sizes. Often they bring stuff all in the same kind of thing. So when you're giving people clothes and they're all dressed up as if they're part of the military or a school, it just impacts their psychological well-being. Working with vulnerable people means that they're very susceptible to other people's opinions. So I think it's always important to be realistic and try not to raise someone's expectations over seeing them in Germany in a year, or telling them that they should cross a border that is dangerous and that they could die on. I think there has to be responsibility. And that's often difficult to do when you care about someone, which is also what happens with smugglers. Like, they tell them, it's going to be great, you're going to get to Greece, it'll be 2 months, and then you're going to be in Austria or Switzerland. And working on ground, you know that this is not the case.
Some people, they have some relatives, some cousins, some family, some aunt or uncle or someone like that in a European Union, sorry, in a European country. And someone they didn't have. Just they come without anything. Like they don't know to where is Europe, where is France. Just they give pay for smugglers, and smugglers show for them the way.
Smugglers, they are not helping. They are just making plans for the money, and they just try to take money from the people. When I was leave Afghanistan, they told me you will be in Germany in 15 days or 20 days. But I'm already here been 19 months, and I'm still stuck here.
Thank you.
Sería ideal que las ONGs no existieran. Sería un mundo ideal, ¿no? Y ojalá. Y al fin y al cabo, el objetivo del voluntario es desaparecer, ¿no? Lo que te aporta un voluntariado y el contacto es genial. Bueno, aprendes, yo creo que aprendes, y ellos en general, esta situación te aporta a ti en lo personal más de lo que tú acabas aportando. Te abre la cabeza, te enseña muchísimo, te da un contacto con otro mundo que probablemente hasta ahora no habías tenido, y te llevas a casa pues muchas sensaciones, bueno, es una experiencia intensa, ¿no?
Volunteering is a responsibility, so it is not a place you come to find yourself, or it's not a holiday, you need to sort of go. And often with volunteering, you want to have like a connection, you want to be able to tell people what you did or see things, but the most important work is working 8 hours in a warehouse and sorting clothes, and not so many people, it's not the idyllic sort of view of volunteering, like that's not what you expect to do when you go to Serbia or Greece or Turkey. But yeah, that could be the most helpful thing.
Hay voluntarios que llegan, están 2 días y te cambian el formato, ¿sabes? Y luego se van y hacen unas, se asocian con otro tipo de ONGs o de grupos de otro tipo y dan charlas, y es realmente maravilloso cómo vienen, están un tiempo, se van y luego siguen y siguen y siguen y siguen y siguen.
Creo que hacer voluntariado es algo que puede ser muy bonito para el individuo que lo hace, ¿no? Pero también es muy importante para la comunidad en la que estás trabajando y en la que estás llevando a cabo ese servicio de voluntariado. Porque es lo mismo que estábamos hablando antes, porque de otra forma esta gente no recibiría esa ayuda, no recibiría esos servicios, no recibiría ese apoyo. Entonces, dado que no hay recursos económicos para pagar a toda esta gente y que lo haga, ¿no?, es esencial que haya voluntarios.
Volunteering is important because volunteering starts at this point where governments and organizations and countries are not able to provide enough help anymore. They're not able to do this, what they should be doing in another way, but it's just impossible. Or maybe things would be good if more things would be done. So volunteering starts at this point where other help is needed that could not be provided because of money, because of economic, maybe also because of social reasons. So people are going to step in and trying to improve the situation.
To motivate volunteers to come is just, yeah, come for the experience, just to meet great people and learn the value of like true compassion, of being able to learn from each other and be able to help people out that are in need. Because it's just a very special feeling to be able to do something like that. Because in a world where, like the two words I could sum up the world right now is just fear and misunderstanding. And if people can get past that, then I think the world would be a lot nicer of a place. But we have to start somewhere, and I think it starts within like us, this organization, the people that you meet, the refugees, and just go from there.
Yeah, and I think volunteering is a great way to open your mind and, you know, your horizons to the larger world out there. And I mean, if you're volunteering abroad, it's a great way to meet people from other cultures, work with, have direct contact and work with them, and help, you know, ideally help resolve and help chip away at some of the problems of the world.
La màgia del voluntariat és que tu, volent-ho, tenint tots els privilegis que vulguis i més a casa teva, decideixes un dia marxar-te, ja sigui més temps o menys temps, ja siguin unes condicions més o menys precàries, però te'n vas a un lloc nou a intentar ajudar aquella gent que ho està passant malament. Aleshores, crec que la gràcia del voluntariat i el que aporta al voluntari és adonar-se que no tot va tan bé com pensem, que sí que tenim problemes a casa i sí que ningú és feliç les 24 hores del dia, però quan te n'adones que hi ha gent que no tingui res, sinó que té problemes molt més greus que tu, et fa veure el món d'una forma diferent. I no només és això el que ens diuen sempre, això de que hi ha gent que no té res i que tu ho tens tot i per aquest motiu t'hauries de preocupar. El més sorprenent, i sobretot treballant amb refugiats tant sirians com de l'Orient Mitjà, és que en molts casos són persones, són famílies, són gent que ha tingut una vida semblant a la teva fa poc temps. Són gent que potser fa 10 anys tenien una casa i vivien tranquil·lament a la seva ciutat i que de cop i volta, pel motiu que sigui, han hagut d'emigrar i marxar.
I think the beauty of volunteering is that anyone can do it. I mean, you just have to find what's suitable for you. You know, and once you've found that, it's fine. You know, it's very much a question of if you're willing to put the time and the effort into it, then you can do anything, really. I've never met anyone who I would say was totally unsuitable for volunteering.